Star Wars Chewbacca Bowcaster Review. This is a Nerf blaster made by Hasbro, but it has Star Wars trademarks all over it, looking like Chewbacca's bowcaster from Star Wars. Included is the blaster, the stock that attaches in, the bow arms, which also come detached, the little ammo thing, the attachment sight thing, darts, and the instructions. So going over the blaster in a bit more detail. Up front, it does have a goofy looking front end, but not much going on other than the priming mech. This is a band powered bow plower blaster. There's not an internal mech or anything. This string is what powers the blaster, and if you cut that, your blaster is no longer going to fire. To prime the blaster, you can just pull back the string and then it locks into the rear right there. Then you just push a dart right into the barrel and you're loaded, ready to fire. It's very quiet because it is band powered. There's no spring smacking inside, so it's stealthy, I suppose. Moving back, there is an InStrike tactical rail up here. This is a Nerf-compatible InStrike rail, so if you have any other Nerf blaster attachments, it will fit on that. And this attachment will also land onto any other Nerf blaster into any rail. This attachment is completely useless as far as firing this Nerf blaster. It is clearly just a prop thing because you can't even look through it. It's clearly there just for appearance. Style points, woo! Moving down, the grip is comfortable, easy to use. The trigger is easy to pull. It's all very straightforward Nerfy stuff. The stock is not meant to be detachable. Once you click it in there, it is there, but it's a stock. It's too small to actually use unless you're a hobbit, but it does look cool, I guess. And then up here, there's a little ammo holder. It's not permanently attached, so you can pull it out if you don't want it or whatever, but it does hold 4 extra darts, making it a little bit quicker to reload. And then, of course, the Star Wars little logo is right there, and then also on the other side. Firing the blaster is a little bit unorthodox, but you pull back the string, and then you load in a dart, and you fire. It is pretty slow. So shooting the blaster is pretty fun, but it's very slow and a little unorthodox. I would not recommend this blaster to anybody looking to perform in a Nerf game and actually like shoot at people and win Nerf games. It's clearly just a plinker. And the velocity of this blaster is also a little bit under average. The normal Elite blasters are shooting about 70 feet per second. This is a little bit under that. So you might get outgunned, but you're also using a bow-powered single-shot thing that takes like a few seconds to load, so clearly you're not in it to win it if you buy this one. My overall opinion of this blaster, I think the prop-esque feel of it is pretty nice. It looks sort of similar to the bowcaster. It's supposed to do that, obviously. The proportions are too small for me. I wouldn't recommend this blaster for a cosplay, like to buy this and then say, oh, I'm done with my cosplay, I don't have to make anything, because the proportions are a little weird. But in the prop tier products, it'll come down to aesthetics and how much you like the blaster, not as much my opinion on it. Since I'm in it to Nerf, I'm not in it to cosplay, but different style. That is my opinion and review of the Bowcaster. If you'd like to purchase one, there's an Amazon link, buy link in the description box below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.